Photography is an art, and art cannot be photographed on automatic. I am going to teach you how to take control of your camera and make an artist out of you. Welcome back to the channel. My name is Kenneth Lawrence, and this is part 2 of my photography tutorial series. If you're new to the channel and if you missed part 1, you can click on the card right here, and I'll also leave a link in the description. Part 1 was all about manual mode and the workings of aperture, shutter speed, and ISO. In this video, I'm going to be talking about white balance, how to use it correctly, and how you can create dramatic moods with it, all within your camera and without the use of any editing software. Remember, you have to master getting it right in camera before you try to fix it in post. If you enjoy this video, make sure to hit the subscribe button and the notification bell so you don't miss any future uploads. So let's begin your second photography class. Now, there may be several instances where you've taken photographs but have noticed that the colors in your frame do not look very natural, especially in the skin tones. Sometimes they look too yellow, and sometimes they look too blue. Well, that's not because you have a bad camera. It's just that your camera thought that that particular color temperature of the scene was correct, and so it white balanced for it accordingly. White balance simply is the adjustment of color temperature in your camera to make your image look natural. When you white balance correctly, the whites in your frame will look white, and the other colors will be rendered without any color cast. You can also use this feature to portray a variety of moods. Before we understand how to properly white balance an image, let's understand what color temperature is. Here's a skeletal color temperature chart. On the far left is candlelight at approximately 1800 Kelvin. And on the far right is a clear blue sky at approximately 10,000 Kelvin. Anything beyond this and we go into the infrared and ultraviolet sources of light. Let's come back to the ranges that we are more familiar with. The range to the left contains warm sources of light, and the range to the right contains cool sources of light. Remember, yellow light is warm and blue light is cool. Sunrises and sunsets have a warm color temperature and clock in at approximately 2500 Kelvin. Filament bulbs also fall in the warm range and sit between 2500 Kelvin and 3500 Kelvin. These light bulbs include Edison bulbs, incandescent bulbs, and household tungsten bulbs. Navigate towards the center and the sources of light become neutral. Daylight has a color temperature of approximately 5500 Kelvin. This overhead sun is basically white light. Electronic flashes and other LEDs fall within a similar range. Navigate further right and we enter cool sources of light. A cloudy sky has a color temperature of approximately 6500 Kelvin. And natural bounced light, indoors or in the shade, has a color temperature of approximately 7500 Kelvin. Now that we know what color temperature is, let's find out how it affects our imagery and how we can properly white balance in camera to achieve a look that's natural. Here's a photograph that has a yellow color cast because it was taken using a warm light source. The skin tones are completely off, and it's not very pleasing to look at. But you can correct this. Since warm light falls in the range between 2000 and 4000 Kelvin, all you need to do is manually reduce the color temperature in your camera till it matches the temperature of the light source. This adds a blue hue to your image and neutralizes the yellow tones across the frame. Similarly, for photographs that have a blue color cast, you need to add a yellow hue to neutralize the cool tones across the frame. Let's say you're shooting a photo story or a subject in burst mode, because telling that particular narrative requires you to showcase multiple photographs. Selecting a fixed color temperature will render a consistent look all throughout your images and make them look professionally executed. Auto white balance will most definitely have a shift in warm and cool tones as you pan your camera to take those multiple shots. The more you understand color temperature and how to correctly white balance, the more you need to experiment with it and bend the rules in your favor. Do this artistically and you can create dramatic moods. By adding just the right amount of warmth, you can give photographs a soft, sunlit feel that's very pleasant to look at. Take this image for example. It's exposed well, composed well, and portrays a beautiful moment. But add a tinge of warmth and you accentuate that emotion even more. You're manipulating hues to tell a story now. Shift the color temperature into the cool zone and you're moving from a happy look into one that is moody and portrays sadness. You can create a late evening look with it and make any season look like winter. White balance is a simple tool, yet there is so much you can achieve with it. If you're someone who uses filters to create looks, I strongly recommend that you put a pause on that and play around with color temperature to tell your story. Let me know how it went in the comments below, and if you have any doubts, feel more than free to ask them as well. I will answer each and every one of you. In future uploads, I'm going to be talking about histogram, focal length, composition techniques, raw image processing, and a lot more. If you enjoyed this tutorial, please hit the like button and subscribe. Your support is going to help me build this channel and community and take it a long, long way. See you in the next one. White balance simply is the color. Now that we know what color